Victor Gao is the Vice President of the Centre for China and Globalisation and Chair Professor of Suzhou University in China. He was also once a translator for the former Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping. He joins me now from Beijing. It's nice to have you with us. I wanted to first of all just get your view on how you saw this submarine announcement.
Well, first of all, up to this point, Australia is part of a nuclear-free South Pacific. And I think this is actually a great value to the people in Australia. Now, armed with nuclear submarine to be produced locally in Australia, unfortunately, Australia and the Australians will lose that privileged status. Meaning, armed with nuclear submarine, Australia itself will be a target for possible nuclear attacks in the future.
Can I just stop you there, Victor? Australia will be a target for nuclear attack from whom?
You do not need to know whom it will be, but as a logic, no one wants to target any nuclear-free zone, which now includes Australia.
Australia has said it will not be carrying nuclear weapons. These are nuclear-powered submarines, as indeed China has, but we're not talking about nuclear weapons. So how is it a target?
Listen, do you really believe you can trust what Washington or even what London say? I would say the watershed moment will be if Australia is armed with nuclear submarines to be locally produced in Australia, Australia will lose that privilege of not being targeted with nuclear weapons by other countries. And that should be the wake-up call for the Australians, the 23 million Australians. Do you really want to be a target in a possible nuclear war, or you want to be free from nuclear menace going forward?
It is extraordinary, isn't it, that you're talking about nuclear war and attacks on Australia. Now, do you believe what you're saying echoes what the Chinese government believes as well, that Australia is a target?
Listen, as a general policy, Australia is not targeted with nuclear warheads right now. Why? Because it is part of the nuclear-free South Pacific region. Now, if the Australian governments want to deprive that privilege from the Australian people by going nuclear with nuclear submarines, that's the wake-up moment for the 23 million Australians. They will lose that privilege of not being targeted with nuclear warheads going forward. As simple as that. Anything you do will have a consequence. This is the most profound consequence. And Australia and the United States and United Kingdom are being accused of violating the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, which is a gross violation of international law. And it will again have consequences.
You mentioned the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty. Australia says it will not be carrying nuclear weapons, and it is working with the International Atomic Energy Agency after this announcement. But I want to go to that threat. It is extraordinary, again, to hear someone say that Australia is a target. Are you saying that Australia will be targeted by China? Because when you talk about nuclear war, are you envisaging a conflict where China attacks Australia? And are you warning that Australia now is under threat?
Listen to me. I have been as straightforward and as simple as I can. That is, Australia right now is part of the nuclear, non-nuclear South Pacific region.
But I don't think you are being straightforward, because I'm asking you, is that China who is making the threat? Are we under direct threat of attack now from China? That's the question I'm asking you. From whom would we be attacked?
You need to do your own math. You need to use your own brain. You need to do your own basic research. And my point is very clear. Australia, by going nuclear, will lose the privilege of not being targeted with nuclear warheads going forward. That's as simple as that. And if anyone believes by possessing nuclear submarines, they can still claim that do not carry nuclear warheads. Come on, can you sail your nuclear submarine into any port in New Zealand? Why should New Zealand, your closest neighbor, oppose any nuclear submarine sailing into their seaports? That's the logic you are talking about. That's the logic of how you want to fool the Australian people, how they really want to deprive their very coveted privilege of being in the nuclear-free zone right now. They do not know how much Armageddon they are talking about. Because by going nuclear, you destroy your nuclear-free zone status.
Victor Gao, why would Australia not look for a closer relationship with the United States? Why would it not look into the possibility of nuclear-powered submarines when it sees China already with nuclear-powered submarines, increasing that capacity, making threats directly about invading Taiwan, which could have consequences for a broader conflict in the region, militarising and claiming the islands of the South China Sea? Is the provocation, is the aggression not coming from China's side?
First of all, a couple of points. You mentioned several very important points. One is that anyone in the world should know that there is a blood treaty between the United States and Australia, meaning if the United States fire any single shot, you, the Australians, will have no choice but to fight together with the United States, with whatever enemy you choose, in Afghanistan, in Korea, for example, in Iraq. Wherever the Americans find themselves in the war, the Australians are on the American side, as if the Australians do not have any brain power left, as if you only have your muscles to fight with the Americans. That's the first point. In China, we know from day one of this blood treaty between the Australians and the United States. Now, you talked about Taiwan. Taiwan is part of China. All the international organizations acknowledge that. The U.S. government, ever since 1971, acknowledged there is only one China, and the People's Republic of China is the sole legal representative of China, and Taiwan is part of China. You are talking about invasion, which is completely wrong.
I'm not talking about invasion, Victor Gao. Xi Jinping, sir, has said he reserves the right to use force to reunify Taiwan. He is the one talking about an invasion of Taiwan, is he not?
Absolutely. Listen to me. The unification of China's mainland with China's Taiwan will happen by peaceful means, preferably, and by non-peaceful means if it is necessary. No force in the world can stand in the way of Chinese reunification. This is the common will of the more than 1.4 billion Chinese people, including people on China's mainland, as well as the majority of the people in Taiwan, 23 of them, the equivalent size of the Australian population. No country will be able to deprive China's mission of national reunification. It's not invasion. It is the reunification of China's mainland with Taiwan. If the Australian government wants to stand in the way of that, be my guest. You will see what will be the consequences to Australia.
Well,
and I don't believe the American government will want to shed blood on the American soldiers over the Chinese reunification.
Well, the United States does have an agreement with Taiwan to support it in the event of an attack, to potentially arm or even potentially join in the defense of Taiwan.
The United States has never offered to defend Taiwan. The United States just want to be the biggest arms dealer with Taiwan, selling them more sophisticated weapons. And in doing that, they are in violation of the three communiques. No government ever since 1971 has ever pledged to fight on behalf of Taiwan, to shed the blood of the American soldiers for China's reunification. No. And I can bet with you, the Americans will not allow their sons and daughters to die for China's reunification. That will be in itself a futile attempt, and that will be itself involving huge consequences. I hope you will never call the unification of China as mainland's invasion of Taiwan. Both mainland and Taiwan are part of only one country, that is China.
Victor Gao, just a final question to you. Listening to your language today, it did not take 30 seconds for you to talk about war, to talk about nuclear war, to make threats that Australia would be directly attacked in the event of a conflict. For anyone listening to this right now, why would people not be concerned that we are in a trajectory to conflict in this region?
No, I think you need to ask who pulled the trigger. Allow me, look at how mad the French people and the French government are now against Australia. They've recalled their ambassador from your country. They've recalled the US, their ambassador to the United States. Why? Why so much anxiety and excitement in France? For anything the Australian government chooses to do, there will be consequences. What I say today is not a threat. It's as simple as logic. Say what Victor said is logic. You do one thing in geopolitics, it will lead to the next logical step. And the next logical step is Australia will lose the privilege of not being targeted with nuclear warheads once they operate nuclear submarines.
Victor Gao, that's all we got time for. Again, I appreciate you giving us your time. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me.